Hello everyone, welcome back to StrideWise Finance. After a tough 2022, the S&P 500 had started 2023 on a very good note, notching up almost 7.5% just in the Q1, mostly led by the big tech companies from technology, Microsoft up 20%, Apple almost 27%, Google 18%, Meta a huge 76% run up so far, Amazon 23%, and Tesla, which by end of December was like $100 or something, is almost $208 now, up 69% for the year. The banking sector did get jolted in the month of March because of the crisis with the Silicon Valley Bank and Signature Bank. Year to date, we see technology doing the best, up 21.5%, followed by communications, up 17.23%, then consumer cyclical, up 15%. So basically, the three sectors that got beaten up very hard in 2022 are the leaders so far. Likewise, the sectors that did the best in 2022, likewise, the sectors that did the best in 2022, like energy, healthcare, financial, are at the bottom of the pack so far in 2023. But the purpose of this video is to show how my portfolio has done for the month of March, how much dividends I got, and how far my goals have been achieved. So without any further delay, let's get started. To start with my M1 Finance portfolio, where the portfolio value is $21,400 currently. Year to date, it's up 1.62%. which compared to the SCHD ETF, which is down more than 3%. So my M1 portfolio has done relatively better. Looking at individual slices, technology has done the best so far, up 13.27, followed by my whole world ETF pie, more than 6% up for the year. Communications, likewise, more than 6% up. Materials up 3.41. Consumer discretionary up 3%. My income pie is up 2.5%. Staples up almost 1.8%. Utilities almost flat, just up 0.65%. And coming to the negative performers, we see energy just almost flat, down 0.28%. Likewise, industrials down 0.5%. Real estate down 3.25%. Financials down 4.37%. And healthcare down 6.36%. I have a link to my M1 portfolio down in the description. And I also have a referral link for M1 Finance in the description notes. So if you do open an account using the referral code and deposit $5,000 within 30 days of the account opening, but you and me would get $100 of bonus. So that's $100 of free money, which you can invest into your favorite stocks or ETFs. So you can help my channel by using the referral link. Looking at the dividends in my M1 portfolio for the month of March, we start with Enbridge at $3.79. We do see a dividend deduction for 57 cents. That's because Enbridge is based out of Canada. So for those companies which are not based in US, you do pay some taxes on the dividends earned. That's why you see the deduction. After that, we see Pfizer for $2.42. Then JP ETF, $7.07. And JEPQ, $6.22. Johnson & Johnson, $2.14. Cummins, $2.12. And Sherwin-Williams, 51 cents. And Target, $1.88. UPS, $1.70. Then we have Walgreens, $2.39. 3M, $2.48. Lionel Basel, $2.35. Factor Supply, $1. Consolidated Edison, $2.10. McDonald's, $1.52. Yalta Income, $1.37. Whirlpool Corp, $2. Prudential Financial, $3.21. Arbor Realty Trust, $6.81. Then we have BlackRock, $2.01. Qualcomm, 82 cents. VYMI ETF, $1.50. VIGI ETF, $1.30. And L3 Harris, $1.37. Lockheed Martin, $2.12. SCHD ETF, $7.41. The Vanguard Small Cap ETF, VBR, $3.27. Vanguard Growth ETF, VUG, 88 cents. Vanguard Value ETF, VTV, $2.76. Vanguard Energy ETF, VDE, 95 cents. Vanguard Utilities ETF, VPU, 55 cents. And we have the Vanguard S&P 500 ETF, VOO, $3.76. Goldman Sachs, $1.72. T. Rowe Price, $2.41. Devo ETF, $2.88. Bank of America, $1.73. Broadcom, $1.72. Digital Realty Trust, $1.55. PepsiCo, $1.50. And finally, Union Pacific, $1.72. I track my investments through Google Sheets. And we see here the one for my M1 portfolio, where currently my entire portfolio here is in a negative 3.25%. This portfolio currently yields 3.97% with an annual income of $849.83. So adding up all the dividends from my M1 portfolio for the month of March, it comes down to $96.44, which is $1.70 less than what I was paid in December. That's because few of the companies tend to pay less in the first quarter of the year, but they make it up towards the end of the year. So usually your Q1s are slightly lesser than the previous Q4s. But when I compare this to what I was paid in 2022, you see a nice increase from $81.53 to $96.44. You can see that happening at a quarterly level also, where it's $211.09 for Q1 compared to $169.70 for the previous Q1 in 2022. So overall, 2023 got a good start, overall $211. But this is a chart that I always look up to see that nice growth in payments quarter over quarter. We do see a $2 reduction here from Q4 to Q1. But like I said, this ladder should grow higher as we go into the year. Now looking forward, here we see expected payments in the month of April. So we can see companies such as Coca-Cola, Walmart, Vichy Properties, Merck, Medtronic, Oracle, Comcast, Cisco. Some amazing companies out there. Adding up all the expected payouts for these companies, it comes down to around $46.50. So Q2 should start on a good note for my M1 portfolio. Now coming to my Fidelity portfolio, its current value is currently $20,610. This portfolio currently yields 3.21% with an annual income of $660.65. Overall, this portfolio is down 2.15%. Even in this portfolio, for the month of March, we saw dividends from varied companies all the way from WC Energy, Pinnacle West, Kroger, Aflac, Walker Hannifin, Southern Co., Amgen, Chevron, American Electric, Manulife Financial, and so on. Adding up all of these adds up to $108.52, which is the highest payment ever for a single month in my Fidelity portfolio so far. This easily beats out the December payment for almost $96. And if I compare it year over year, where in March of last year, 2022, it was just $36.47. So it's three times that. It's amazing. Looking at quarterly wise, even here, this is the highest quarter ever so far. Overall, 2023 started on a good note. And here, you can see the nice laddered growth quarter over quarter. Looking into payments expected here, these are the companies that should pay me in month of April. This almost comes down to $28. So that should keep this 2023 Q2 value growing higher. Finally, coming to the third part of my portfolio, that is Econs. Its current value is $5,171. Like I always say, this is my set it and forget it account, where I invest $25 every week, which brings my investment to $100 every month. Apart from that, the roundups feature, which is what I like Econs very much for, it keeps adding those investments higher based on what I purchase. I made videos in the past regarding how Econs works and how it is good for starter investment. Now, this is where I started my investment back in 2017, and I have not stopped investing into this. Like you see, $100 every month plus the add-ons from your roundups just keeps this account ticking. This is a simple four fund ETF portfolio. We have VOO, which is the S&P 500, your IGH, the medium cap, IJR, the small cap, and IXUS, the international. I track my Econs also through Google Sheets. You can see this portfolio is currently in the positive, up 7.57%. It's a low yielding portfolio, just 1.56%, with an annual income of almost $81. We do see some dividends in this portfolio for the month of March, almost $11.19 from VOO, 82 cents from IJR, and $1.86 from IJH. So adding up all the three individual portfolios, we get a final portfolio value currently of $47,182. Portfolio currently yields 3.37% with the current annual income of $1,591.36. Overall, the portfolio is currently down by 1.68%, but that doesn't matter. As we keep on consistently investing into the portfolio, the investment will get averaged out. And looking at the goals I've set for myself, by end of December 2023, I'm expecting to hit $1,800 in my income. So currently, I am 88.4%. For my five-year goal at the end of 2025, my goal is to reach $2,500, of which I am 63.65% through. Looking at other dividend metrics, if I divide my annual income into monthly, it gives me $132. If I do it by weekly, $30.60. Daily, that's $4.36. If I do per hour, that would give me 18 cents. If I do an 8-hour workday, that would be 77 cents. These are some fun metrics to keep track of. But you can see whether by the time you retire, the income that you have, will it be able to sustain you through your retirement? And here, as you see, my dividends growth quarter over quarter. So yeah, these numbers keep me inspired. See that every dollar I invest into my portfolio, I'm getting something out of it that will sustain me into the future. This is what I say, no matter the markets are up or down or sideways, just keep investing consistently into quality stocks and ETFs, and they'll do the work for you. That's all I have in this video for you all. Hope you all liked it and found some value from it. And if so, I'd really appreciate if you could hit that like and subscribe buttons, so that YouTube can recommend this video to many more people out there, and that would really help this young channel. And please do share in the comment section, how's your portfolio doing? The dividends from your portfolio. Let's keep in the interaction going on. And until we meet in the next video, let's try to do as much as possible to be financially healthy and keep taking those small strides towards financial freedom. See ya. Bye.